Well, I guess my earliest memory of church would be going to a church in where I used to live in Montrose, and I thought it was kind of boring because we sat through a service and then they did the communion and we ate the stale crackers, drank the gross drink and left and, you know, went to lunch. So I didn't really feel anything at that point in time. That's why I kind of was a little questionable on my faith, because I just didn't know what it was truly about. I saw people singing and stuff and enjoying themselves, and I really didn't know why, because I would see them doing that, and I never really felt what they were feeling, and I never understood what they were talking about or what the preacher was preaching about or anything about that. If I could thank God for one thing in my life, it would probably be my friend Isaac, because without him, I probably wouldn't be here. And honestly, without being here, I wouldn't even possibly be alive, because I was struggling with depression, and I really thank him, and I thank God for putting me where I am, because if I wasn't here at this moment, then if it wasn't at that moment that God intervened from my path in life, then it could have taken a very drastic turn. I had a little faith, and I was a Christian, and I said I believed in God, but I didn't really know who he was. And then I walked in here, and they sang these songs that made so much sense, but I didn't quite understand them, if that makes sense. And then they sang these songs wholeheartedly, and they sang them like I've never seen before. And they I really wanted to be part of that, and so that's really the pivotal point where I knew where I was supposed to be. Completely changed my life. I went to youth camps and stuff, and I could really, that was the first time I really felt the Spirit of God, and I knew who God was and that he had a plan for me, and I really understood that God wanted me. But God is so rich in mercy, and he loved me so much that even though I was dead because of my sin, he gave me life when he raised Christ from the dead. It is only by God's grace that I've been saved. To me, the gospel is really just the greatest love story you could tell. I mean, it's talking about someone distant. It seemed like it was God that was so distant that we couldn't talk to, that you weren't allowed to even barely know about. And then he sent a person, he brought himself into existence, and he lived a sinless life, a perfect life, and then he just died for us. We didn't deserve it. There was no thing that we deserved except for death. And to understand that he was murdered for us, and just, it's so sick to think that he was killed, such an innocent person, and still we know that that's the true gospel, because he did it for love, and he loved us so much that he was willing to do that. But God really, the moment he took our transgressions and he got whipped and beaten and humiliated and put on a cross and bled for us, is the true reason he's worthy of our praise. Because when he did that, he didn't just do that because why not? I mean, no one wants to do that, but he did it because he knew that there was no other way that we would be saved. And so he knew that. And so we know that these worship songs mean something, because we're singing to a God that saved us in a vicious, bloody way. He saved us, and he showed up out of nowhere and did it for us. The people that don't have Christ in their life, one of the biggest things they're missing is joy, because a lot of people think they have happiness, and happiness is just temporary, but joy is this eternal thing that the only way you can have it is by understanding where you're going and what you're going to do with your life. And what the biggest way to have joy is to understand that you're saved. If there's someone out there that doesn't know God's plan for them, it's really just stay in prayer, because God reveals himself when you talk to him, and he he's waiting for you to talk to him, and he's been ready every day of your life. He's been ready for you to talk to him. And I guess there's not really any other part of my story. I mean, like, I could be cheesy and say my story is still being written and everything, but I guess one thing I need to say is for the Christians out there and stuff, that our goal is to make Christ known, and our goal is to push the kingdom forward. And it's just, we need to work with everything we have, every tool we've been given, just to push his kingdom. We're the world changers, and if we work together, then we could change this world for the better.